Welcome back. This is OT Time on Plus TV Africa. Now moving on to the plenty drama of over the weekend. And we've dealt with one, Burna Boy. So this is Cynthia Morgan and Jude Okoye. And I think it's a three people thing now because Maydi went in. But let's start with Cynthia Morgan and Jude Okoye first. So she says since she left the record label, right, that her life has, I don't know, become hell, that she had sicknesses or diseases, yeah. And she had to go to, is it Togo or Cotonou, to take care of herself, and she spent a year there, spent all her savings, and the shame was too much for her to want to come back, so she decided to settle there and just do something for herself. But now, I think fans want her back. I don't know if this is happening without her knowledge, but apparently she spoke, right? Yeah, she spoke, and there is a consent for them to try to want to bring her back in, yeah, opening a GoFundMe and all that.
Davido also said she should call
him. That was after the whole drama. Mm. That was when Davido came in. I mean, that's a good gesture anyway. I don't know why people are
also
bashing Davido. Yeah, Tacha said she would do everything to promote her music once he drops and all that. But the real question now is Jude Okoye's label, yeah, and Cynthia Morgan. He has come out to say that the accusation of him stopping her from using her stage name is an absolute false, and that it is not possible for him to do that. But that's the one I want to correct, that it is absolutely possible for you to actually stop someone from using the stage name, because we saw that play out with the case of Kiss Daniel, which was why he changed from Kiss to Kiss.
But Jude's point was that Cynthia Morgan is a birth name, so he can't stop her from using.
You can actually stop a person from using any name, whether best or not, from as for business. You can't stop them from bearing Cynthia Morgan. So but for business, you can. It's just like the case of Rihanna and the dad. I mean, Fenty is his name, right? But that's in court. So you can actually do that. So I don't think that's a real excuse. But if he said that is not what he did, then of course, I definitely have to believe that is not what he did. But is that possible to be done? Yes, it depends on the kind of contract you have signed with the people. And I also saw, is it Peter or Paul coming out to speak away? So I think it's time for me to shut up.
So for me personally, I'm a little bit torn. I don't want to be on anybody's side, because I always say that you never ever know the full story, especially when it comes to this kind of business. I don't really understand the music industry, but from the way, if you look at all the things that we have seen where artists are fighting with their record label, it always feels like as if there's something missing. And going back to what Gbemi said, because I read what she wrote, and I was like, that was when I started having doubts about the whole story. Because I read what Gbemi said, I read what other music label owners, what they were saying, and they were like, a lot of people just blame the record labels. Nobody looks at the fact that they made investments in these artists. So I understand where Jude is coming from, because according to him, what he said is not holding her against using her name, but what he has is a Vevo account, because he wants to make his money back. Which she also said that he was the one who sponsored her music videos. So of course, if you make an investment, it's not rocket science. You want to make back your investment, or you want to make profit from the investment. So I understand that part. But what I now don't get is, why is it that all the artists that were signed to this particular record label, that's not Side Records, whether it is Maydi, whether it is
Maydi
Cynthia Morgan.
Maydi wasn't signed, actually.
It was part of
He's part of the drama, but he wasn't signed.
Yeah, but okay, he worked with them. But why is it that the people that have worked with you, the artists, why is it that none of them are actually, you know, making it, or why is that they are not successful? What is it that was in that contract? Because the truth is, we don't know what was in the contract. And Cynthia Morgan kept on referring the contract, and a manager said that they were the ones that drafted the contract. So there's a lot of...
Her manager is not on her side anyway.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Her manager is not even on her side. Her manager said that she was the one who brought all of this on herself, which is why I said I started having like a little bit of doubt.
It's hard to pick a side with that. I think there's truth in both parties. But if you're going to... You have to use two different caps for these issues. You can use an emotional cap to understand where Cynthia's coming from. But if you put on your business cap, then you understand fully where Jude is coming from.
Jude says she's been free since 2017.
Yes, and she even released music under her new name, Madrina.
When you said
now that you mentioned Madrina, he also said that he advised her not against changing her name from Cynthia Morgan to Madrina.
She was the one who wanted to change her name to Madrina. That's why I said I started having doubts, and I was like, story.
When you mentioned now that why is it that a lot of celebrities or musicians or talents under his record label, I think they haven't really done a good job in picking people who are long lasting. So even at Maydi, like, he had soundtrack, but what else did he really have? Some people are just not convertible with them from talents to profits, even though people might like your music. And I suspect that that's what's going on here. Cynthia was nice, but she wasn't like, she wasn't slapping hard. Like, I don't know, it wasn't she like
was a, Cynthia Morgan.
Cynthia Morgan was like away from, on away, the same level with Burna Boy. No,
but it didn't last very long, is what I mean.
All the because other of the issue she was having. This is the first time this issue is coming up.
Yeah,
she just it came up after a while. You remember when she was dragged online as well for not paying her rent?
Yeah.
Where she was staying in a Molly Estate or something, and then I think the landlord came out of who were just talking. I can't remember clearly now, but there was an issue of her owing millions of naira, and then. The story died like that. She didn't even come out to refute or to say anything. I think that was when she moved to her Cotonou or wherever she said she moved to. So this story, like you said, is difficult to pick sides. Yeah. I'm not comfortable with the fact that Zipita, that you said, came out to start talking in this light, because, I mean, whatever the issue is with you and your family, brothers, we are hoping that you pull, after deciding to go your separate ways, you're trying to patch it up and be family or just be civil, right?
I don't think they're trying to do that.
I don't think so.
That was what I said. Like, I was hoping that was what would be happening.
We've seen them interact before several times, and it hasn't really
clearly,
been in that.
Yeah,
in that
clearly
light,
it's not. It's not getting better anytime soon.
Whenever Peter talks about this issue, he always paints Jude in a bad light. So for him, this is like finally the confirmation. Yeah. You guys can finally see it. So I was actually expecting him to say something about
it. I'm sure Jude is not the most nicest person. Like interacting with his businessman, but I don't think he is doing anything that is like, what's the word, like unethical. But I don't think every business person needs to be a nice person. It'll be nice, it'll be a nice sprinkle on the top of the cherry or whatever, however you say that statement, but I don't think it's necessary. But I want more answers. I like that people are jumping on board, like Davido and Tacha, but I think I've learned with time, especially with Jesse, because Jesse was the last time I did that. When he got attacked, I was like, oh my God, Jesse's been attacked. And then he said, so now I'm just like, let it simmer before I start to make claims and jumping
picture.
On people's,
But regardless of what the full picture would end up being, Cynthia Morgan needs help. People are already donating in the, what's it called?
No, but this is more than just Cynthia Morgan. Now this sounds like
Davido is not saying he wants to sign her.
No, it's not just
she even said she doesn't want to be under any label. She just wants to collaborate.
I feel like there's two things going on. Cynthia Morgan needs help, but we're destroying a man's reputation on the other hand. So he needs to figure out if that was worth.
Reputation was already being destroyed. Okay.